I know I've been gone for a while, but there's a good reason. I've been building a new studio. It's not quite ready, but there's one thing I do want to show you. If you look behind me, you'll see two doors. They're not just any doors. Watch what happens when I go through one of them. Let me show you again. One more time, but this time, watch this. Aha! Gotcha! Get out of here! Now, let's go back to the old studio and I'll show you how I did this in Final Cut Pro. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to show you how I filmed and edited the cool magic door effect you just seen. And it's actually really simple for filming. I set my camera up on a tripod, set everything to manual, and controlled as much lighting as I could. I started filming and walked through the doors behind me a few times, filming each take at least a couple times, just so I had lots to work with. I also made sure to film just the room for a few seconds without me in the shot, just so I had a clean plate to work with. To edit this effect, let's import this clip into Final Cut Pro and make a new project. Grab your clip and drop it down into your timeline. If you need to straighten or reframe your shot, now's the time to do it. This way, you don't have to repeat these steps for every clip after you cut it up. Same thing goes for any color grading or color corrections. Once your clip looks the way you want, it's time to start cutting it up. Find the take you want to use for your first shot, go back a few frames, and use a keyboard shortcut Option left bracket to trim the start of your clip to your skimmer. Skim ahead to where your subject just starts opening the first door, and press M on your keyboard to add a marker. Find the next take you want to use, and place your skimmer on the frame where a second door just starts to open. Press Command B to blade your clip on that frame. Grab the second part of your clip and drag it up above your timeline, lining up the start of it with your marker. What I also found worked good in my example was lining up the audio waveforms of the door closing in both clips. Next, to blend our two clips together, we need to add a mask to our top clip. Press Command 5 to open the effects browser, select the masks category, and grab a shape mask. Add this to your clip. Move the mask over to the left side of your screen, resize it, and add a bit of feathering to blend the edges between your clips. Move your playhead to where your subject is just about to get cut off by the mask, and blade your clip. Select the second part of your clip, go to the video inspector, and delete the shape mask. Repeat the same steps for your next scene. So, find a frame where the first door just starts to open and add a marker. Skim to where the second door just starts to open on your next take and blade your clip. Drag the second part of your clip above your timeline and line up the start of it with your marker. To add the same shape mask as before, select your previous clip with a mask and press Command C to copy it. Go back to your top clip and press Shift Command V to paste attributes. Deselect everything except for the shape mask and click the paste button. Move your playhead to where your subject is about to get cut off by the mask, blade your clip, and delete the mask in the second part of your clip. In our next scene, our clones are going to interact with each other, so we'll use a slightly different method. We'll start off just like before by placing a marker on the frame where the first door just starts to open, blading our clip on the frame where the second door starts to open, and line up the start of the second clip with a marker. Now, to time the interaction between our clones, we need to be able to see both clips at the same time. To do this, select your top clip, and in the inspector window, bring down the opacity slider to about 40%. Use markers to mark the actions in your two clips, and line them up for perfect timing. Add a shape mask to your top clip, and this time, use the green control handles to stretch it out to cover the entire frame. Grab the middle handle, and move this mask over to the side of your screen. Move your playhead to a frame where your subject is just about to be cut off by the mask, and in the video inspector, add keyframes to your mask's transform and feather parameters. Move a few frames ahead, move your mask, and bring down the feather amount to zero. Bring the opacity of your top clip back up to 100%. Now, we have a few frames towards the end of this effect where the two clones actually overlap, so we'll need more precise masking. For this, we'll use a draw mask. Move your playhead to the frame right before your clones overlap, and add a marker. Hold down the Option key and drag up on your top clip to make a copy of it. Make sure it lines up perfectly with the clip under it. The reason we do this is sometimes, if you blade a clip in the middle of a sentence, you get a bit of a stutter in your audio, so we'll just use the audio from our bottom clip and use the top clip for video. Trim the start of your clip to your marker, and trim the end to right where the first door is just closed. Bring the volume all the way down in this clip. Go to the video inspector, delete the shape mask, and add a draw mask to your top clip. Add control points to draw a mask around the part of your subject that overlaps, which in my case is just my hand. Add a keyframe to the control points in the inspector. Go back one frame and move your control points to follow your subject. Repeat this for every frame in your top clip. The last thing we need to do is disable a shape mask in the second half of our bottom clip. Like I said before, we don't want to blade our clip in the middle of a sentence because it might affect our audio, so we'll just keyframe our shape mask. Place your playhead at the end of your top clip, select the clip under it, and add a keyframe to the transform parameters of your shape mask. Move your playhead ahead one frame, and resize your mask to cover the full video frame. Another thing I did in my example was add a nightcrawler effect at the end to make myself disappear. If you want to learn how to do that, let me know in the comments below, and if there's enough interest, I can do a video on that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.